The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, into the district of Decapolis. And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment and begged him to lay his hands on him. He took him off by himself away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ears and spitting touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, Ephphatha, that is, be open. And immediately the man's ears were opened. His speech impediment was removed and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone, but the more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished. And they said, He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
He took him off away from the crowd. Bakit kailangang ilayo ni Jesus ang pipi na kanyang pinapagaling? If you notice this, he took it away from the crowd. To remind us that the primary reason of God's incarnation is not to heal the sick, but to save souls. That's why there are healing that you can hear God saying, Go, your faith has saved you. But today, you did not hear it. You did not hear it. The sick was simply healed. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, remember that. What is important is salvation, not just healing. Sad that you are healed, but you are not saved. I'd rather be sick and saved. Mahalaga yon. Anong meron sa unang pagbasa? Anong meron sa unang pagbasa? All that Solomon had, he lost it. He lost it. What was given to him is because of his father, David. Can you imagine? You have 12 kingdoms, you have 12 tribes, and the prophet divided it as they divided their cloak. 10 were taken to remain for the sake of his father. For the sake of his father. Yung mga nagtatanong, Father, bakit yan? Hindi naman nagsisimba. Parang bless. Nagtanong niya ba yan? Father, yan hindi naman nagsisimba. Why that someone never go to mass? Or that somebody committed sin? How come they are blessed? Seemingly. The word is seemingly. Maybe God was just faithful to his parents. Please listen. If we keep the treasures we have, in spite of the evil we have been doing, maybe God was just faithful to the goodness of your parents. Kaya nga minsan sinabi ko yan, live your life well so that you can be a blessing to the next generation. Don't just think of yourself. the people under Solomon was blessed because David was good and God made a promise to him. So don't be complacent. Don't be complacent. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, kaya nga pag meron tayong ginagawa, tinatanong natin, anong idudulot nito sa kinabukasan na susunod sa akin? Hindi po ba, ano? Sa susunod sa akin. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, ikalwa, minsan narinig nyo na mula sa banal na kasulatan, na ang alin, that what you think you have will even be taken away from you. What you think you have will be taken away from you. Why? Because whether you like it or not, good or blessing comes from goodness and punishment comes from what? Wrongdoing. Hindi naman mahirap isipin 'yon. Di po ba, ano? Kaya palagi nating sinusuri ang ating mga sarili. Bakit ako kailangan mangumpisal? Bakit kailangan ako mangumpisal? Hindi lang sa aking kasalanan. Upang 'wag isisi sa kasunod o sa aking kasunod na lahi. Hindi ko masabing sa aking mga anak, hindi naman ako magkakaanak. Ano po ba? Ha? But my dear friends, my brothers and sisters, do not forget that. Do not forget that. Mabuti ang Diyos. Mabait ang Diyos. Mahabagin ang Diyos. Ang bawat kautusan ay hindi nagbabawal upang sabi nga siilin, talian ang iyong mga kamay para hindi ka maging malaya. Ang lahat ng kautusan ay inihayag ng Diyos upang magdulot ng pagpapala. Laws were given not to prevent us to exercise our freedom. Laws were given so that we can be blessed. Please, listen to that. Laws were given. You shall not have other God beside me. You keep Sabbath holy. Thou shall not use the name of God in vain. Honor your mother and father. Thou shall not kill. Thou shall not commit adultery. Thou shall not steal. Thou shall not bear false witness. Thou shall not covet thy neighbor's wife, including their husband. Thou shall not covet thy neighbor's good. All those laws were given, not that we are, what? Our hands are tied and being deprived of our freedom. Those laws are given so that we can live in the blessings of God. Kaya nga, anong paalala ko sa mga magulang? Minsan sinabi ko yan. Huwag mong sasabihin sa mga ito, bawal yan, bawal yan, bawal yan, bawal. Hindi. Ituro mo kung bakit. Hindi po ba? Ituro mo kung bakit. Minsan sinabi ko yan. Ano sabi ko? Huwag mong pilitin ang iyong mga anak pumasok sa school. Sabi nung nanay, ha? Hindi ba? Hirap na akong papasukin ng anak mo. Tapos, sasabihin pa ni Father, wag pilitin ang anak pumasok sa school. Bakit? Kasi naiwan lang ang pag-iisip sa pumasok sa school. Sabihin mo sa anak mo, ano ang meron kapag ikaw ay merong pinag-aralan? Help them learn to value the things, not simply to obey the law. Not simply to obey the law. Anak, hindi kita pinipilit mag-aral. Pero, pag hindi ka nakatapos, anong iyong kinabukasan? Maliwanag yun. Mayroong kinabukasang nakaakibat sa mga taong nag-aaral. Kaya anong paalala? Ipaalala sa anak na mag-uwi ng pinag-aralan, hindi lang ng diploma. Sapagkat hindi lahat ng nag-uwi ng diploma may pinag-aralan. Di po ba? Hello? Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, kaya nga pag sinabi mong, oy, kumain ka ng gulay, tapos yung tatay di naman nakain ng gulay, wala rin, di po ba? Ano? Ha? Huwag mo sasabing masarap ang gulay, sinungaling ka, hindi masarap ang gulay. Sino may sabing masarap ang gulay? Kung masarap ang gulay, lahat yan ang kinakain natin, tama po ba? Hindi, sino may sabi sa iyo? Minsan lang, nag-uusap kami, pinag-uusapan namin, kainin mo yung okra, nakakababa ng blood sugar. Yung mukha. Kasi iniisip mo agad yung naglalaway-laway, di ba? Di ba? Kainin mo ang palaya. Ang pait eh, natural. Kung matamis ang palaya, hindi yan ang palaya, ice cream yan. Di po ba? Ano? Mga minama, I hope you're getting the point. Don't focus on the law. Focus on the blessing that comes with the law. Kaya nga anong sabi ko 2 days ago, that you honor your mother and father. Don't focus on the law. Because the next statement that comes with that is what? Those who curses their mother and father will die. Will die. Ganun kasimple. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, again, if you are enjoying something today, don't just tap your shoulder and say, oh, ang galing ko, ang galing ko. No. Thank the Lord for the gift of a good parent. Thank the Lord for the gift of a good parent. Because you might just be enjoying the gift that God has given to them because they were good. Amen. Someone who in the opening of the year had death in their family, then one of his children got sick, another one got sick, and sent a message, said, Father, pinagbabayaran ko na ba ang aking mga kasalanan kaya nagkakasakit ang aking mga anak? I did not reply, but I prayed, I hope it's not. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, do not forget this. Some people do not believe this. But if you read the book of Genesis, if you read the book of Genesis, you can find when you sin, the next generation suffers because of your sinfulness. Not only the second, not only the third, but the fourth generation. When it is written in the scripture, I believe it's true. But, what's a better story? If you do something good, God will bless you to the seventh generation. To the seventh generation. That's how generous God is. Going back to the story, why did God set apart the person? Because healing is not for show. Healing is not for show. Don't just seek God for healing. Seek God for salvation. Again, my dear parents, live your life well so that the grace of God will flow to your children. Kahit naman ako, pari, I always say this to God, help me to live my priesthood well so that my parishioners will be blessed. Wala akong anak at hindi ako magkakaanak. Pero aking panalangin that I have a priesthood that will be easy for God to bless my parishioner. So that you have to pray for your priests. Pray for your priests. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.